is now made up of healthcare professionals. Dr. Alan Courtney says there's real anger amongst his colleagues about the lack of masks, gowns and gloves, which could well have protected them. Sky's Noel Phillips reports on a doctor's story from the front line.
This is Alan Courtney in happier times. He's a critical care doctor at the epicentre of this coronavirus pandemic. His patients aren't just from outside his hospital. He told me he's now having to treat his own colleagues in intensive care.
Realising half your ward is filled with healthcare professionals. Having a guy not even 40 who was supposed to be sent home that day from recovering from COVID just dying suddenly on the wards. Having, you know, a 13-year-old boy not have his family by him as he died, not being able to say a goodbye, looking at him. I mean, I'm glad I'm emotional because I'd be more worried if I wasn't.
What are those emotions you feel when you're having to treat a colleague who is a patient in ICU?
I mean, there really isn't anything more soul-destroying than having to treat a colleague, I can tell you that, and I wasn't expecting that. There's anger that this has happened to them, and, you know, could there have been anything to have to avoided it? Could having more protective equipment, more masks, more gloves, more gowns, could that have prevented it?
PPE, or personal protective equipment, is important in the fight against COVID-19. But some doctors are being forced to decide whether to risk their lives to treat patients without proper protection.
We're risking our lives for having to do it even more so because we don't have the right equipment, which is something that the government should be giving us.
What is the age range of patients who you're dealing with?
There are young people who are also dying, so it's not just children growing up, it's children dying and their parents not being allowed in. It's people not being able to attend the funeral because they have to self-isolate.
An insight into the sacrifice being made by one doctor, but a number of other healthcare workers putting their lives on the line is growing.
Are you prepared for colleagues who may die fighting this battle?
I mean, we're expecting them. We're expecting a few, even from our department. I mean, can we ever be ready? I would say no. I feel it's going to happen. Don't think I'll be ready for it.
Noel Phillips, Sky News.
And we wish the doctor and his colleagues well.